Okay, so I mean, okay, so just a little bit, I need some, sorry, 1 second, please. What? I lost file, sorry. Because I forgot to close previous one. Yeah. 1 second, please. Okay. It looks like I suddenly close. Yeah. Is it visible now?
No.
No? Ah. No. Sorry, let me restart in such a case. I hope now I will be correct. So again, share screen. I choose the file. I'm here, I guess.
It works.
Yeah. Sorry for this delay. So I had such a delay because I have two different files, and the point was that it was difficult for me to understand how I can operate by these two files simultaneously. So I will start from the shortest version, from the first one. So you see, what is the object? We have such hydrodynamic type systems. This is just a concept. So usually people, when they look on such a type of systems, they say, oh, we know this object. This is quasi-linear system of first order. Quasi-linear system of equations of first order. Indeed, so this system is linear in first derivatives. Corresponding coefficients depend
okay,
on.
So suppose that this is, okay, this is probably something like this, F21 inverse.
Frank.
So the formula I wrote first was maybe, in, well, different convention basically.
Frank Nijhoff. Can I continue?
Yes, please.
Yeah, so usually people say that this system is quasi-linear, indeed, because characteristic, velocity matrix elements, Vij, they depend on U. So non-linearity of this system is only on coefficients, Vij. But actually, usually, what is the difference that I would like to emphasize here, that usually when people say quasi-linear system of equations, this means that coefficients Vij depends on U and also X and T, so on both independent variables simultaneously. But now we restrict our consideration only on such a case where these coefficients depend only on functions U. No explicit dependence on X and T in such a construction. Okay, so I am speaking only about this particular case, which we call hydrodynamic type systems. This is the first point. Second one, assume that these systems can be written in such a local Hamiltonian form. This is a statement one. So this system has a local Hamiltonian structure and coordinates U that you saw in the beginning. I'm speaking about this formula, functions U, which depend on X and T, but now we speak just about functions U as independent set of entries U1, U2, etc. So we say that this Hamiltonian structure, or better to say, corresponding Poisson structure, I'm speaking about these brackets UK and H. So when we write UK and UM under appropriate point invertible transformation, these brackets elements can be written in this canonical form in terms of A. So what means letters A, K, A, A, N? What is it? This is just functions which explicitly depend on unknown functions U. So we can say basic set of coordinates U1, U2 up to UN, and functions A small are nothing but combinations, some maybe very complicated dependencies of these entries U1, U2 up to UN. So again, up to invertible point transformations, these presentation of hydrodynamic type system from coordinates U to form of functions A is just recalculation. You start from system written in terms of U, and of course the system you can rewrite up to again invertible point transformation in terms of A small. So in terms of A small, which people usually call as flat coordinates. So in these flat coordinates, corresponding Hamiltonian hydrodynamic type system can be written in very simple form that I'm going to tell a little bit later. So this is the first statement. We say that we start from hydrodynamic type systems. They must be Hamiltonian. What means Hamiltonian? Definition is presented in this slide. So corresponding hydrodynamic type system should be written in such a form where UK are elements of Hamiltonian structure, and AK are nothing but so-called flat coordinates, where corresponding Hamiltonian structure can be written in such a form where matrix eta KN is a constant non-degenerate symmetric matrix. So again, this is constant elements. Eta KN are constants. Okay, next step. These hydrodynamic type systems also should be integral by Tsarev, generalized Hodograff method, which was introduced 2 years later after definition of Dubrovin-Novikov Poisson brackets. So also two restrictions, which are very important. What means integrable by Tsarev, generalized Hodograff method? This means that once we start from that hydrodynamic type system, we have velocity matrix Vij. And then we can say, let us compute its so-called characteristic roots or eigenvalues of this matrix with one up and one sub indices. Once you do it, you can call them mu i of u. And these all characteristic velocities must be in such a construction pairwise distinct. But second statement is that all components of corresponding Hantis tensor should vanish. So please don't ask me about definition of Hantis tensor. This is huge expression. This expression is written in many different papers. And if you have such a tensor Vij with one up with one sub index, first you can construct so-called Nienhuis tensor. And if you know components of Nienhuis tensor, then you reconstruct Hantis tensor. And if you compute all coefficients of Hantis tensor, if all components vanish, this means that such hydrodynamic type system belong to class of hydrodynamic type systems, which are integral by Tsarev generalized Hodograff method. So just a few words about Hantis tensor. Nevertheless, I'm not going to tell in detail about that tensor. I just would like to say that this tensor contains three indices. Plenty operations are packed inside of this Hantis tensor. This means that all computations are so complicated that, let's say, 30 years ago, nobody was able to do anything with corresponding computations. And just after applications of some symbolic software, people realized that some computations could be simplified for lower dimensions. So I mean, when number of field variables U1, U2, up to UN, when so N capital is small. If N is small, in such a case, computation is more or less, due to application of symbolic software, is applicable. If, of course, N is arbitrary, growth of all computation is so high, so it's indeed not trivial problem in general. So, okay, two statements you already see here in these slides. So first is necessary that such hadronic type system possesses local Hamiltonian structure. Second statement is such a system must be integral by Tsarev generalized holograph method. Two points. Okay, next point, that this system also should belong to so-called Yegorov class. Again, in my talk, I am not going to go in plenty and in very deep details concerning the concept of Yegorov class. I will just emphasize two important features. One of them is written at the bottom of this slide. So we say that given hydrodynamic type system has such a Yegorov property, this means that such a hydrodynamic type system has a pair of conservation laws such that conservation law flux Q of first conservation law coincides with conservation law density of the second one. So the letter Q appears in two conservation laws simultaneously. This is not a generic situation. This is very exceptional situation, but nevertheless, in plenty applications, such a property was observed. And now we know plenty examples in mathematics where such property exists, and plenty examples in theoretical physics, for instance, in aerodynamics, in plasma physics, in hydrodynamics. So plenty real fluids, real guesses have such a property, existence of such pairs of conservation laws. So we call these pairs as a symptom, as a signal that corresponding hydrodynamic type system has a such Yegorov property. What means such a property on another language that I omit in my talk here? The definition of Yegorov property on a language of hydrodynamic type systems is that such a system has a metric which is of Yegorov class. That concept was introduced by Gaston Darboux more than 130 years ago in France, when Yegorov, Dmitry Yegorov, he is a Russian mathematician. At that time, he was a student of Gaston Darboux, and Gaston Darboux suggested to investigate to Yegorov such a class of metrics, which he called, not only Darboux, but plenty of mathematicians at the time called potential metrics. But once Yegorov had some distinguished results, Gaston Darboux suggested that let us call these potential metrics Yegorov. So we call Yegorov metrics if they are potential. And statement is that if hydrodynamic type system, which is integral by Tsarev generalized holograph method, has a pair of conservation laws such that Q simultaneously appears in two conservation laws, then this means automatically that corresponding metric has a such potential property or Yegorov property in another language. So that object eta Km, which you see here, eta Km, this is such a metric which is written in flat coordinates. So once Gaston Darboux called potential metric, he called metric written not in flat coordinates. That metric was written in different coordinates, which I am not going to tell now in my talk. These so-called Riemann invariants, Riemann invariants, these are such coordinates which also are connected with original coordinates U by invertible point transformation due to vanishing of Hantis tensor. So if all characteristic velocities mu I are pairwise distinct, and if all components of Hantis tensor vanish, then one can introduce corresponding Riemann invariants. Riemann invariants, they are functions of letters U such that this hydrodynamic type system can be written in diagonal form. So you see here, matrix of velocities Vij is n by n matrix where all entries are fulfilled. But if we go to Riemann invariants, this means that this matrix of velocities became diagonal. So I'm talking about.
Just somehow related to the flatness condition.
Yes, this is precisely that I'm talking about. I would like to say that existence of flat coordinates, existence of this local Hamiltonian structure of Dubrovian-Novikov means automatically that corresponding metric is flat. This is flatness condition.
I thought that the Hantis tensor is a curvature tensor. Am I right?
No. Curvature tensor, this is Riemann tensor of curvature. I will speak a little bit later, Dima, a little bit later about metric. So it will be clear to understand me why I'm distinguish these two objects. So here, Vij, this is so-called affinor tensor with one up and one sub indices. But metric, this is a tensor with two up indices or with two sub indices. So two different objects from differential geometrical point of view. Okay, so now we would like to introduce the concept of the associativity WDVV equation. So what means WDVV? Of course, I never met this object before Dubrovin. When Boris Anatolyevich Dubrovin wrote his first original paper in 1992, he precisely explained, of course, abbreviature WDVV, Witten, De Graaf, Verlinde, Verlinde. So few papers were written independently, to the best of my knowledge, Verlinde, Verlinde, and Witten, De Graaf, about the same object, which later people realized that they can call as WDVV associativity equations. What is the object? Let me just shortly explain you from the language of hydrodynamic type systems. You already saw hydrodynamic type system in previous slide, which was Hamiltonian. So this means we can consider such a family and commuting hydrodynamic type systems. So please look carefully again on all entries here. AK, A with up index K are flat coordinates. H with sub index S, these are so-called Hamiltonian densities. And eta, Km, that you already know, these are constant symmetric non-degenerate matrix. Again, let's look here. This is matrix eta in the right-hand side at the bottom of this slide that you see now. Eta, Km, constant non-degenerate symmetric matrix. Okay, so now I am here. I have such a hydrodynamic type system. This is standard object in theory of hydrodynamic type systems. But Dubrovin observed that if these Hamiltonian densities H with subindex S are nothing but partial derivatives of unique of common function F capital, then compatibility conditions give us immediately the system presented at the bottom of this slide. So you see what is written here. I just was a little bit lazy to write third derivative of function f in such a form as it was written here, first derivative. So df das I could write as f with subindex s. So this standard notation, I instead of this expanded form could write first derivative of function f with just small subindex s. Here's the same story. If you see here Fijk, this means that I wrote third derivative of function f with respect to dA small I, dA small j, dA small k. So I have, in fact, system of algebraic equations of second order quadratic relationships between third order derivatives of unique of common function f capital, where eta ks are constants. But please be very careful. I wrote here n commuting flows. I checked compatibility conditions of all these n commuting flows. I wrote WDVV equations. But Dubrovin said that I'm not going to investigate this object. I would like to add some simplification without loss of generality. What I'm talking about, his idea was following. We have, again, this n commuting hydrodynamic type systems whose compatibility condition lead us to WDVV equations, which you see here. However, he said, let us, instead of n commuting flows, consider n minus one commuting flows, n minus one, such that we identify first time variable T1 with X. So we say we consider not family of n arbitrary commuting flows, we consider only such commuting flows where one of these time variables T1 we identify with X. Of course, I think so. It's not easy to believe that instead of n flows, we can consider n minus one, and this construction will be, as I said, without loss of generality. However, this is possible to prove, and I just omit this proof, but of course, this proof takes maybe just few lines, actually, if to be honest, on one slide. So this is not too big computation. So when Dubrovin and his notes, first notes, wrote about so-called unity condition, this precisely that you see here. Unity condition means that we can observe as a consequence that matrix eta km, just please be very careful, in the beginning, eta matrix was with two up indices. That was an important feature of this matrix that I said, constant, symmetric, and non-degenerate. So if matrix is non-degenerate, this means that I can compute inverse matrix. So here I am speaking about inverse elements, eta km with two sub-indices. And he proved by just straightforward computation that eta km is nothing but third order derivative of common function f with selected index one. So a1 in this construction is selected field variable. So from this point of view, if you start to reconstruct conservation laws, one of them h1 that you see here, h1 is just can be written explicitly h1 as a quadratic expression with respect to flat coordinates AK. So once we spoke about family of n commuting flows, we had no any restrictions on conservation law densities HS. Again, no restrictions. So all that we know that if HS satisfy to this condition that every H with subindex S is nothing but first derivative of common function F. In such case, we have system of WDVV associativity equations, but without restrictions that you see at the bottom of this slide. So this restriction appears only if you identify T1 as X. But again, if you would like to recompute construction from one flows to N minus one, it takes few lines. If you would like to do some statements, better to forget about n commuting flows. Better to start immediately from this basic n minus one commuting hydrodynamic type system, as it was announced in first Dubrovin paper due to introduction of concept unity. So unity condition, this precisely statement that you see at the bottom of this slide. Unity means the matrix elements are determined via third order derivatives of common function F capital. So this F capital, I forgot just to say, is solution of this W associative equations, Dubrovin called as a prepotential, or some people call it as free energy. Okay, so this is such an object. Again, we had hydrodynamic type system. We had hydrodynamic type system. Such a system is Hamiltonian. Such a system is integral by Tsarev generalized Khodogorov method. And such a system belongs to Egorov class. Three these items are enough that such a hydrodynamic type system will be an element of Dubrovin construction. So here we come to hydrodynamic type systems, which are Hamiltonian, and we have WD associativity equations for common function F. And if we introduce so-called unity restriction at the bottom of this slide, this means that one of conservation law densities H1 can be recomputed and found explicitly as quadratic expression with respect to flat coordinates AK, and all others, H2, H3, up to HN, of course, are determined by first order derivatives of this common function F capital. Okay, so just a few words about Hamiltonian structures that I promised to say. We say that hydrodynamic type system has a local Hamiltonian structure if corresponding element Gij is a metric tensor and whose curvature is zero. So Dima, now I would like to answer on your question. Answer could be given in following way. That we say we are looking for first order Hamiltonian operator that is written in square brackets expression. And we are looking for just pure differential operator. So we are looking for Hamiltonian structure determined by pure differential operator. Statement is following. Pure differential operator of first order means automatically zero curvature flatness condition of corresponding metric tensor Gij. And vice versa, if we start from first order differential operator whose metric tensor has zero curvature, if second term can be interpreted in a way that you see here, gamma capital IJK are Christoffel symbols of the Levita-Chivy connection, then automatically we have Hamiltonian structure for corresponding hydrodynamic type system. So in flat coordinates that I promised you to say, our hydrodynamic type system can be written in this very compact form where eta ka km is nothing but corresponding metric tensor gik. But again, gik here is a metric tensor in arbitrary coordinates u, but only in flat coordinates this metric tensor became constant. This special representation of metric tensor can be written in terms of matrix eta. So eta km, this is just special definition of metric tensor in flat coordinates. So we deal with hydrodynamic type system written in flat coordinates AK. This invertible point transformation connecting flat coordinates AK and original coordinates U, which we utilize for presentation of hydrodynamic type system. Okay, so now we consider.
Maxim, I'm sorry.
Yes, please.
Could you return to the previous page? how restrictive is the form of the Hamiltonian structure in this case? So I understood that it is more particular than at the first page.
No. This is the same. I just, you see, let's go to the first slide. Yeah. So I just shortly wrote here standard representation of Poisson brackets without explanation what is hidden inside of these brackets. Mm-hmm. So here I just wrote brackets, but now here I explained what was written in these brackets. So
It is an interpretation of such local coordinates as the flat coordinates in some metric.
Yes, AK are flat coordinates, yes.
Okay.
So that you see, let's for simplicity speak about all that written at the bottom of this slide. So here you see matrix eta KM with two up indices. Let's go to the first slide. Yeah, this object eta KM. So this is just alternative presentation of, so when I am speaking about Hamiltonian structure, I am speaking correspondingly, simultaneously about a Poisson bracket. So if I wrote that some hydrodynamic type system has a Hamiltonian structure, let's go again here. Sorry for this, my jumps. This means that corresponding hydrodynamic type system has a Hamiltonian structure, which was written in the first slide here. Yeah. So nothing different, nothing special, nothing particular.
Okay.
I'm just speaking about these objects.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm speaking about next picture. So assume that we have not only one set of flat coordinates, assume that we were able to find two invertible point transformations, AK and BK, of still the same set of functions U. So we had some flat coordinates AK. We would like to find them. This is some more or less complicated linear problem, linear system of equations, which you need to solve. And of course, this linear system of equations in partial derivatives contains a variable coefficient. So in general, we should not expect that such system can be integrated, but assume that we are able to do. We found flat coordinates AK, and in a way, in computations, we observed that corresponding linear system of equations possesses not only unique, but two different solutions. One of them we still call AK, and second one we can call BK. So this means that our system has simultaneously two local Hamiltonian structures. It's possible. Sometimes this possible. Few words I will say a little bit later. So we have possibility to write given hydrodynamic type system in two different alternative forms. One of them via flat coordinates AK, second one can be presented via another set of flat coordinates BK. And here could be formulated the following problem. Let me go back to the first slide again for a few seconds. So we have hydrodynamic type system of equations. And as you said, first statement was such a system assume has a local Hamiltonian structure. Why I said assume? But statement is following. If we have some hydrodynamic type system, we have some special way how to compute or the system has local Hamiltonian structure of Dubrovin-Novikov type or not. So this means that we need to solve some linear system of equations, partial derivatives with variable coefficients. And actually, if to be honest, in general case, such a linear system has no solutions. So this means that in general case, any given hydrodynamic type system cannot be equipped by any local Hamiltonian structure of Dubrovin-Novikov type. This is impossible in general. However, even this is impossible in general, we can say, let us try to select all subcases where such a hydrodynamic type system can be equipped by at least one local Hamiltonian structure. And now, of course, we know for last, of course, 40 years that this is very, very complicated problem, unsolved problem in general, not unsolvable. I'm just speaking about unsolved. So this problem belongs to so-called inverse scattering transform class. So we are speaking about problems which can be solvable by inverse scattering transformation. So in this way, you can compute plenty of particular solutions, but not all of them. And if you would like to say, I would like, instead of description of hieronymic type systems equipped by one local Hamiltonian structure, I would like to describe all hieronymic type systems which can be equipped by two local Hamiltonian structures that you saw already here in this slide. This is more narrow task and more simple problem. But in general, again, this is very complicated problem. So once I mentioned description of local Hamiltonian structures, that problem in some language is equivalent to integrability of 3D, three-dimensional integral systems by inverse scattering transform. Once we spoke about two local Hamiltonian structures, this means that we are speaking about integral systems, integral by inverse scattering transform in 2D, not in 3D, in 2D. So again, one local Hamiltonian structure means we need to solve three-dimensional integral system. Two local Hamiltonian structures, this means we need to solve two-dimensional integral systems, integral by inverse scattering transform. Of course, you can say, what will be if we have three local Hamiltonian structures? How many hieronymic type systems can be equipped by three local Hamiltonian structures? How many systems can be equipped by four local Hamiltonian structures, et cetera? How many local Hamiltonian structures one given hieronymic type system can possess? And here we have no complete description. We have just very particular results. For instance, maximum of local Hamiltonian structures is n plus one. So what it means? We have some hieronymic type system which has only n equations. So if system has n equations, maximum of local Hamiltonian structures is on one equation, on one structure more, n plus one. And this case was completely presented 1981, as I remember, or maybe 1992. So this case was is nothing but so-called coupled KdV equation. So complexity of this problem, you can understand me on following language. Again, this is maximum. We can formulate instead of this problem, following problem. Let us solve the following task. We would like to describe all hieronymic type systems which can be equipped by exactly n local Hamiltonian structures. My statement is following. This problem still is open. So even n local Hamiltonian structure is open problem question. And
do you assume that they are compatible?
Of course, we would like, I'm speaking, we start from the beginning, we assume that we would like to describe only compatible Hamiltonian structures. Of course, if we will ignore this statement, of course, such a problem will be very, very complicated in general. So for simplicity, we say, let's all our families of Hamiltonian structures will be compatible for simplicity. So even in this simplest case, this problem still is open. We don't know how to describe n local Hamiltonian structures in general. Open question. Okay, so we have Yegorov hieronymic type systems, and you remember that H small with subindex S is nothing but partial derivative with respect to corresponding flat coordinates AS. So then we, you see on the right-hand side, we have such a formulation of Hamiltonian Yegorov hieronymic type system in such a form that expression in parentheses is nothing but second order derivative. So you see, I just change index k from up to lower place. Under this transformation, very trivial, of course, such a system looks a little bit more simple. Of course, here you cannot see longer a matrix element eta km, but of course you remember that in left hand side I wrote a with some index k. In right hand side I have derivative respect to a with up index k. So please don't forget about this. Okay, so since in right hand side we have symmetric expressions, this means that, for instance, for k equal one, we can just substitute instead of k small equal one, and we can say what can happen with when we compare second central term and third term in right-hand side expression. Then we can compute, sorry that last line not so visible, so I can of course pronounce all coefficients which are written here. I just would like to select all terms in free energy F capital on two blocks. I call first block as a so-called metric part. Metric part, this just a cubic expression. First term is 1/6 eta 1/1. Second term is 1/2 a 1 in degree 2. And second block is capital function psi. This function, as you can see, no longer depend on first entry a1. So usually here is some could be misunderstanding or some unfortunately way how to say ignoring differences between capital function f and capital function psi, lose some meaning of objects, because sometimes people, when they look on function f capital, once they look on equation for WD associativity, they say, I have WD associativity equations for function f capital. But indeed, some people, including, of course, me, including Dubrovin, including many people who deal with WD associative equations, they said, of course, indeed, after substitution of that ansatz where first metric part was cubic in terms of A1 field variable, then this WD associative equation could be simplified, and still equations for function psi capital we can call as associativity WUV equations. So just please remember about this. So usually when people look on equations for function psi capital, they of course remember about matrix eta KM. And of course, every time people remember about that restriction, which you see here at the bottom of this slide. So here of course is a difference between function F capital and psi capital, but since we know this very rigid connection between matrix eta and third order derivative of function f, we know that if we know f capital, we know how to find function psi. If we know function psi, we know how to reconstruct metric part for function f capital for free energy. So in both cases, it's okay. Many people prefer to forget about first entry A1, because function psi depends on smaller number of entries, and in many computations it's very convenient to deal with function psi which depends on a smaller number of entries. So it's just question of taste. Some people prefer to deal with F capital, some people prefer to deal with function psi. Okay, so I'm coming to finish to this slide. First part of my talk. So I just would like to again attract your attention that we had previously in previous slides only family of commuting flows where number of time variables t, t1, t2, t3, etc. was finite. Now we say instead of finite number of time variables, we can consider infinite set of such time variables t. This is the same analogy like people know with Korteweg-de-Vries equation, with nonlinear Schrödinger equation, with Businesco and plenty others. We have no some finite set of integral flows, integral higher symmetries. We have infinitely many of them. And that set, which you saw in the previous slides, was just selected due to all all commutant flows are connected with this restriction that HS Hamiltonian densities are nothing but first order derivatives of common function F. So if you have one single function F, which depends on A1, A2, up to AN, of course you have only N first order derivatives. So you have only N commutant flows. You cannot in this way to construct N plus first flow, N plus second flow, etc. This is not a way. So we say that this is so-called basic set of conservation law of conservation flows. But now I'm speaking about the last slide. I'm speaking about possibility to construct others. And observation was following that if our systems belong to WDV associativity equation set, this means that we can add infinitely many higher commutant flows just in this very simple way. We just, I'm speaking about last formula line. We can write infinitely many flows in such a way that all partial derivatives of conservation law densities HS, such that their partial derivatives are connected with corresponding Hamiltonian densities with of lower level. This means in another language, Dima, that I would like just attract your attention, because I am no longer going to speak about this feature now. This nothing but a reflection of existence of so-called symmetry operator. In this language, usually people prefer to speak about so-called shift operator. Shift operator means acting by operator D with respect to DAK, I can reduce a little bit densities from one level to another one. This way, how to compute lower and lower densities. But of course, in practical situation, this is useless, because people don't like to construct lower densities. They construct higher densities. So this means that if you know such a relationship between conservation law densities, this means that you had some system of linear equations for conservation law densities H, and then you say, I add this extra property, which connects lower and higher conservation law densities. Once you add this extra condition, this means that you reduce complexity of your problem to one step more. So this means that just your computations will be a little bit simplified. Sometimes it works. So in all known, in all very interesting examples where such a property was observed, corresponding computations were correspondingly fulfilled. All expressions were found. All higher commutant flows were presented. So actually it looks like in all important cases, we had so much information that we had no any problems with corresponding computations. So if you have the questions about the first part of my talk, please ask me, because I would like to go to second set of slides.
Are there any questions? No, my principal questions are about geometric interpretations. I suppose it is a subject of the second part.
Actually, yes. Actually, I'm going also speak about this. But anyway, if you will not be satisfied, we can later discuss about this. So let me close these slides. Let me just find a few seconds, please. because I closed the second. I remember. I hope it will be open now. Yeah. Is it visible?
Not yet.
Not yet. Okay, maybe I don't know how to solve this problem in very simple way. So again, let me restart. I'm apologize. Let me restart. I'm very sorry. Share screen. Maybe it works. Yeah. Maybe it works. Share screen. Okay, it looks like now it's okay.
Yes, it's okay.
So now I would like to use my slides, which were based on my common investigation with Boris Anatolyevich Dubrovin and with Sergei Zykov. So we wrote that paper, you see, due to this 11th January of 1913, so many years ago, but I just would like to use this example as illustration of the construction, which is a subject of my talk. So you see, let's consider such a linear system of equations for unknown functions hk. This is linear system with, let's say, given coefficients beta ik, which due to Darboux people call as rotation coefficients. So we have n independent coordinates ri, which are in previous language, I mentioned already, Riemann invariants. So in these independent variables ri, functions bik depend only on this set of independent variables. Then we have this linear system of equations. And if this linear system of equations is compatible, this means we need to check compatibility conditions. This means that we come to so-called, sorry, here not Lamé, we come to Darboux system of equations for rotation coefficients beta ij. Only please remember that all three indices ijk must be pairwise distinct. This is just derivation from Darboux approach. So again, the system at the top of this slide is a linear system of equations where I and K are distinct indices, no any coincidence. Okay, so we say, let's take two particular solutions, which we call HI bar and HI twiddle of this linear system of equations. The statement is that we can introduce some hydrodynamic type system, which is just by construction is semi-Hamiltonian. Semi-Hamiltonian means that correspondent Tsarev generalized hodograph method is applicable. So we again started from that linear system of equations where Ri were independent variables. Then we say, let us now consider Ri as no longer independent variables. Let us consider Ri as dependent functions of X and T. Then we can write such corresponding hydrodynamic type system, which you see here at the middle of this slide, as the center of this slide. So then such a system is integral by Tsarev generalized hodograph method. Here is again not Lamé, Darboux system of equations. Corresponding rotation coefficients are such at the bottom of this slide that they are determined due to these H bar coefficients. And here is just a non-trivial feature. It's of course very difficult to expect in advance, that if you instead of h I bar will replace, if you will replace h I bar by h I twiddle in a denominator and in numerator, corresponding rotation coefficients will be the same. So this is just consequence that I am speaking about linear system of equations written at the top of this slide. So I choose two arbitrary particular solutions. Of course, rotation coefficients beta ik must be the same, but just I use them to construct corresponding semi-Hamiltonian hydrodynamic type system. Semi-Hamiltonian means integral by Tsarev generalized Khodogorov method. Okay, so now I am speaking about symmetric rotation coefficients. This means that corresponding curvilinear conjugate coordinate nets is Yegorov. What means curvilinear conjugate coordinate net? Here was Darboux system. Darboux system describes curvilinear conjugate coordinate nets. So if you can compute all rotation coefficients beta ij, this means that you can describe huge family of this three-dimensional system of equations. And from pure mathematical point of view, this is already interesting problem. You have Darboux system, 3D integrable system, which has huge set of particular solutions, but of course, all of them are applicable to classical differential geometry. They appear in plenty of applications. I'm speaking about submanifolds of any manifolds in of arbitrary codimension. So it doesn't matter how big space where corresponding manifolds is embedded, it doesn't matter. Just a statement is that not arbitrary manifold can be described in this language. Just special set of manifolds could be described by these rotation coefficients bij. Corresponding Darboux system is written here. And if these rotation coefficients are symmetric, that is written in next slide, then we say about corresponding curvilinear conjugate coordinate net as Yegorov, belonging to Yegorov class. So then we can say, we can introduce the potential function P capital just for arbitrary solution of this linear system. And if, please remember that I mentioned from the beginning about Yegorov property, existence of pair conservation laws such the letter B appears twice. So you remember in previous slides, I used letter Q small. It was written PT equal QX, QT equal SX. So B as a such a letter which appears twice in these two conservation laws. So this just reconstruction via corresponding solutions of the given linear system of equations for H capital. So this just a real big simplification of construction if rotation coefficients are not symmetric. So just in a symmetric case, correspondence computations will be slightly simplified. It was enough for Boris Dubrovin when he realized that in language of flat coordinates, all computations which were written originally by Gaston Darboux in language of coordinates RI, so I'm speaking about these coordinates RI, in coordinates of flat coordinates AK, that you remember the first part of my talk. So corresponding equations could be written in language of associativity WDU equations. And it was actually, I think, so very important observation made by Dubrovin, because he was able after that observation extend this understanding to very very interesting, sophisticated and complicated picture. So it was the beginning of story 1992, at the best of my knowledge. So now I would like to speak about one interesting subset of solutions, and again I will speak about, of course, some local Hamiltonian structures. Let me stop for a second. This question for everyone. Okay. So you see, we have hydrodynamic type system of equations. This system, as I mentioned from the beginning, in coordinates Ri, just due to construction, is such that corresponding hydrodynamic type system is written in diagonal form. Velocity matrix Vij now is such that all its entries only belong to corresponding diagonal, main diagonal. Okay, so we will say that such hydrodynamic type system is linearly degenerate if corresponding derivatives of velocity elements, or better to say of characteristic velocities Vi, do not depend on corresponding Riemann invariant Ri. So that you see here Di means D with respect to DRi. This is derivative of corresponding characteristic velocity Vi with respect to Riemann invariant Ri. So then we say such a system is linearly degenerate. And just a few words about this class of linearly degenerate hydrodynamic type systems. This class is very important actually, and has plenty interesting applications. For instance, if we speak about any hydrodynamic type system, I'm speaking about hydrodynamic type system written at the center of this slide. Actually, such a system has only local solutions. So what means local solution? Possibly you know about the concept of so-called gradient catastrophe. This means that for finite time, usually, if you start from any Cauchy data, this system will possess so-called multi-valued solutions. This means that we have some special point. After that, we lose unique solution. This is general picture. But when we deal with linearly degenerate systems, they can possess infinitely many particular solutions which have global behavior. For instance, periodic solution. And this periodic solution exists from minus infinity up to plus infinity. And moreover, of course, I just had no time here to write such corresponding formulas. That example, let's consider integrability of any integrable system like Kertész-Weck de Vries equation, non-linear Schrödinger equation, again, Business equation, doesn't matter. Statement is, its so-called multi-gap or multi-phase solutions, due to Kreutzer, people prefer to say algebra geometrical solution. So all of them can be interpreted on language of hydrodynamic type systems of that type of linearly degenerate hydrodynamic type system. So here is a really close relationship between these two objects. So in another language, we have two different objects, linearly degenerate hydrodynamic type system with special characteristic velocities, again, with special dependencies of characteristic velocities Vi with respect to Riemann invariants. And we have, for instance, Kertész-Weck de Vries equation. In the case of Kertész-Weck de Vries equation, we have multi-phase solutions. The statement, such a hydrodynamic type system also has the same set of multi-phase solution. So two different objects have the same set of solutions. I mean, not all solutions of Kertész-Weck de Vries equation can be interpreted as solutions of some linearly degenerate hydrodynamic type system. No, I just would like to say that some particular solutions of some linearly degenerate system precisely coincide with multi-phase solutions for Kertész-Weck de Vries equation. And the same story we can speak about non-linear Schrödinger equation, about any integral system. Every time this is possible to do. Okay, so now I'm coming back to subject of Hamiltonian hydrodynamic type systems. We have hydrodynamic type system at the top of this slide, written in two different particular forms, or in Riemann invariants, where such a system written in diagonal form, or in a flat coordinates, where you see corresponding Hamiltonian structure. You already saw a system of linear equations for H capital. And now statement is that we would like to construct infinitely many solutions of such a linear system of equations. What to do, how to do, how to construct such a set of solutions. And the idea was following, that we can say in some special cases, of course, not for every case, but in some special cases, we can do it if we can equip this set of linear equations by extra that is written here, by special condition where appears the so-called symmetry operator S with hat. And indeed, we can really, in some cases, introduce such an operator, symmetry operator S hat, such that it's determined by this formula. So what I said, let me explain in another language. I said the following statement. We have Yegorov hydrodynamic type system, which is associated with WDVV associativity construction of Dubrovin. Automatically, this means that such operator S exists automatically, but where functions mu could be chosen as unity only. So instead of all entries here, mu n, I can write only one, 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 one everywhere. So I have only sum of partial derivatives d with respect to drn. You can ask me why it's possible, but just because all functions mu n depend only on corresponding entry rn. And by appropriate scaling, all these functions can be incorporated inside of corresponding partial derivatives. So this just a rescaling of Riemann invariants. And you can of course ask me, why I am able to rescale Riemann invariants? But let's go back here. Please look at the top of this slide. At the top of this slide, you see hydrodynamic type system written in Riemann invariants in diagonal form. If you instead of Ri small, introduce R capital I, such that R capital depends on corresponding Ri entry only. This means that it will be just simplest point transformation. And in left-hand side and on the right-hand side, you will correspondingly write first order derivatives, which will be canceled simultaneously. So this is just how to say gauge transformation of this system. So due to this gauge transformation, symmetry operator S capital every time can be simplified to such a construction that all functions mu n could be chosen as a unity. However, my statement is more wide. Statement is following. I hope you remember that at the beginning of my talk, at first part of my talk, I said about existence of two local Hamiltonian structures, three local Hamiltonian structures, four local, etc. The question is, how many local Hamiltonian structures Yegorov hydrodynamic type system can possess? And actually, if to be honest, I have no any rigid, some very strong theorem. I understand that maximum could be only three, no more than three local Hamiltonian structures. But even case of two local Hamiltonian structures is also very interesting. And in that language that you see here, idea is following. We had a linear system of equations written at the center of this slide. And you say, I am looking for extra linear set of equations, which I numbered by one, which is compatible with the previous set of linear equations. So I'm looking for such functions hi, which satisfy simultaneously to that transformation and to that linear system of equations written at the center of this slide. Once you do such a compatibility condition, you come to statement two. Statement two means that actually if rotation coefficients beta ik are determined, computation of functions mu I is just algebraical problem of not algebraical problem. This is just overdetermined system of first order equations for functions mu I. But please remember that beta ik are functions of all entries R1, R2, up to Rn. But functions mu I depend only on corresponding entry Rk. This means that this is very interesting problem, which theoretically could be solvable completely. But this problem still is not yet solved. So if we are able to find second choice of solutions, first of them, I said you, mu I, we can identify with one. Then we shall be able to find second Hamiltonian structure. For instance, in Dubrovin construction, you see, let's substitute mu I, let's identify mu I as Ri. So if you identify mu I as Ri, let's look on second equation. In second equation, in second term, you will have 1 + 1 and divide to 2. This means that all these factor will be just unity. This means that action of S hat on beta ik means minus beta ik. This precisely condition derived by Dubrovin. This so-called homogeneity condition or effect of presence of so-called Euler field, or in another language, existence of second local Hamiltonian structure, or in another language, this existence of so-called Frobenius manifold. So let us just now collect and emphasize all that we know to this moment. We know following. We have some hydrodynamic type system. This hydrodynamic type system has a local Hamiltonian structure. This hydrodynamic type system is semi-Hamiltonian, or in another language, is solvable by Tsarev generalized Hodograph method. Or in another language, as I just said, all characteristic velocities must be pairwise distinct, and all coefficients of Hantzius tensor must vanish. And also, such a system belongs to Yegorov class. This means that in Yegorov class, we know that such a property AT equal BX, BT equal CX must exist. So this collection of three items means that we are inside of theory of WDV associativity equation. So what I said, I just reformulated all formulas which you can find in papers written by Dubrovin from 1992 and later on language of just hydrodynamic type systems. If you say, I would like to deal with not only one local Hamiltonian structure, but with two local Hamiltonian structures, this means that you come automatically to case of Frobenius manifolds. So Frobenius manifolds, this means that you have Hamiltonian Yegorov hydrodynamic type system, but better to say not Hamiltonian, but bi-Hamiltonian. So this is a subject of Dubrovin investigations, this so-called Frobenius manifold. This is its definition. So in construction, which you can find in many papers written by Boris Dubrovin, you can see unity property, you can see Euler field, and all of them means that you deal with actually hydrodynamic type systems, which have two local compatible Hamiltonian structures. Okay, so now I just again emphasize, here is written extended Darboux system, not Lamé, Darboux system. So we started from Darboux system. We add two extra equations, which actually describe a class of linearly degenerate systems. Sorry that I omit explanation of item 4. It's possible to do. Actually, here nothing complicated. I just would like to say that if you go here, start from this restriction that corresponding characteristic velocity Vi no longer depend on corresponding Riemann invariant Ri. If you check all compatibility conditions with linear equations, which you, for instance, can see here, you definitely come to this set of equations not under the number four. This it takes maybe, I don't know, 10 minutes, nothing complicated. So now we add Yegorov property. And then statement is that Darboux system for all, please remember, three distinct indices, I, J, K, can be extended to all indices. So again, we started from general Darboux system, then we added symmetricity condition, then we added linearly degeneracy condition, and all these extra conditions give us possibility to write instead of Darboux system, the system which you see here at the bottom of this slide. So that system at the bottom of this slide is such that it's valid for all indices and for all distinct and for all coincided indices. This system is correct. And here statement is following that in comparison with Darboux system, this system is completely integrable. So it's possible to write its general solution. This general solution is written here. We have some matrix epsilon. You see, it's very simple construction. Such matrix epsilon that we have Riemann invariants Ri only on diagonal elements. All the rest are nothing but some constants. And we say, let us introduce new matrix beta such that product of matrices epsilon and beta is minus one. Then coefficients of this inverse matrix beta satisfy this that I called extended Darboux system. So we have plenty of arbitrary constants. And this is complete description of, let's say linearly degenerate Yegorov conjugate curvilinear coordinate nets. So this is exhaustive description. No any solutions outside of this class. This complete description. So what was idea that was under consideration of Boris Dubrovin, me and Sergei Zykov? Idea was following. We have such a restriction because we are looking for at least one local Hamiltonian structure, because that system is nothing connected with Hamiltonian, let's say with Hamiltonian structure. Here, no any relation at this moment. But now we would like to say, we would like to find set of restrictions of on coefficients epsilon. So on of diagonal elements of matrix epsilon, we would like to find all restrictions such that this system of equations will have some solutions. So once we do it, we see that some constant Xi I can be found explicitly, but also we have system of equations seven. And maybe it looks like that system seven is simpler, simple system, but this is not so as you can expect. So what we are looking for here, we are actually looking for alpha, we are looking for delta, and we are looking for epsilon, such a system of equations. Just example, let's consider n equals 3. Just straightforward computation give us possibility to find delta 1, delta 2, delta 3, where constants alpha I are free. This means that in case of n equals 3, we are able to describe all three. So in fact, we are able to describe family of heterodynamic type systems, which can be equipped by three local Hamiltonian structures. And the question is how to find other possible solutions of the system seven, that is written at the bottom of this slide, system seven, how to find if number of equations increases. And statement is that if n equals 4, we were able immediately to solve such a system of equations due to, of course, due to some application of symbolic software. by hand manually, it was already complicated. So we had only one restriction on constants delta. But if you go to n equal five, you already have plenty of computations, and already it looks like too complicated to be solved immediately. This means that this problem still is open, and at time when we when we wrote a paper with Dubrovin, at that time we considered most generic case. In most generic case, we were able to simplify most elements of this construction. But nevertheless, I would like to stop here. Of course, these slides I will send you. If you wish, you can distribute these slides for everybody. All other slides of this presentation, you can read, you can ask me later about these slides. I just would like to omit machinery of these correspondent computations. And the statement is that this system of equations, which you see here at the top of this slide, is indeed is interesting. At least for me, it was interesting for Dubrovin, for some people who dealt with, as Sergei Zykov, with such a system of equations. Just again, all that I said here in these last three slides, so this and here I had question about only one local Hamiltonian structure. But if we would like to select two local Hamiltonian structures, this means that correspondent computations will be significantly complicated. And if you would like to consider more and more complicated case, of course, correspondent computations will increase. So nevertheless, I hope that here should be some new view on this construction, a new view which will use maybe different completely alternative tools which will be able to help to solve this problem. But actually, again, let me attract your attention here that we have very simple matrix epsilon, variable coefficients only in diagonal, constant coefficients are only on off diagonal places, and it looks like this problem should be solvable. So I believe I would like to stop here.
Thank you very, very much. The subject is really rich, and I'm glad to hear an important part of this subject. So I suppose that all the question about the geometry and the topological field theory is out of today's talk. So I hope we can discuss it later.
Yes, we can discuss it later. Nevertheless, I just would like to say that I used my presentation just to compare all that I said with all that is written in Dubrovin construction. Because Dubrovin, when he wrote his notes, his idea was to write some common special language, which was very useful for all people who are interested in this subject with different, let's say, mathematical backgrounds. But I used the language of heterodynamic type system to construct a bridge to explain such objects in that form, which usually people are very easy to understand. I'm speaking about, for instance, for students of just with university background.
Mm-hmm. We have a question from Tatiana Kozlovska. Could you see it in the chat?
One second, please. Of course, I should be able. So if you consider associativity, whose solution determines flows of commutation, by Tsarev, I can note on special. Yes, of course, it's true. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Maxim, I'd like to thank you once again for this interesting talk, and I hope we will continue this discussion.
Yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Thank you all. We finish.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye.